Welcome, you are listening to Radio Central News. I'm Chandni, and now news in detail. India saw a record single-day spike of 49,310 COVID-19 cases, taking the country's virus tally to 12,87,945 on Friday, while the recovery surged to 8,17,208 according to the Union Health Ministry data. The death toll mounted to 30,601 with 740 new fatalities reported in a span of 24 hours, the data updated showed. There are 4,40,135 active cases of the coronavirus infection presently in the country. Thus, around 63.43% people have recovered so far. The total number of confirmed cases include foreigners. Of the 740 deaths reported in the last 24 hours, 298 are from Maharashtra, 97 from Karnataka, 88 are from Tamil Nadu, 61 from Andhra Pradesh, 34 from West Bengal, 28 from Gujarat, 26 each from Uttar Pradesh and Delhi, 11 from Rajasthan, 10 from Madhya Pradesh and 9 each from Jammu and Kashmir and Telangana. Punjab has reported 8 fatalities, followed by Assam, Odisha and Haryana with 6 deaths each, Kerala 5, Uttarakhand, Jharkhand and Pondicherry 3 each, while Chhattisgarh, Tripura and Goa have registered a fatality each. Rajasthan Congress MLAs in the Ashok Gehlot camp began a dharna at the Raj Bhavan here, saying they will stay put till the governor summons a session of the state assembly. The MLAs led by Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot arrived there in 4 buses from a hotel on the city outskirts where they have been camping for the past few days. Before heading for the Raj Bhavan, Gehlot said he had requested Governor Kalraj Mishra on Thursday to call a session of the assembly on Monday. But there had been no word from him so far, he said. He threatened that if the demand for convening a session is not met, the MLAs will not be responsible if people gheerow the Raj Bhavan. The Chief Minister claimed the Governor was under pressure from above not to call an assembly session. At the Raj Bhavan, while Gehlot met the Governor inside, the MLA squatted on the lawn, at times shouting slogans in support of the Gehlot-led Congress government. Governor came out to meet them. Later, the MLA said they are starting a dharna. We have requested the Governor to convene an assembly session as per the rules and regulation. The Governor is working on the direction of the centre. We will sit here till the session date is given to us, Transport Minister Pratap Singh Kachariawas said. In a major crackdown in trafficking of pharmaceutical opioids across the country, the Punjab police on Friday said it has busted a drug cartel operating across 11 states and arrested 20 people. The Punjab police also termed the action as one of the biggest crackdown on supply of pharmaceutical opioids across the country. 20 people have been arrested with a huge catch of drugs, drug proceeds, money and 5 vehicles in an operation that spanned over 8 weeks, Punjab DJP Dinkar Gupta said. Giving details of the case and the investigation, he said the drug cartel known as the Agra Gang was pushing pharmaceutical opioids into the market all across India by diverting drugs in huge quantities from the manufacturers, suppliers, wholesalers and retail chemists. Of the 20 people arrested so far, 16 are from Punjab, 2 from UP and 1 each from Haryana and Delhi, the Director General of Police said in a statement here. With the arrest of these gang members, a well-oiled network of drug syndicate pushing consignments to the tune of 10-12 crore of intoxicating pharmaceutical opioids in the form of tablets, capsule, injections, syrups per month into Punjab and other parts of the country has been totally smashed, and thousands of youths who were or could have got hooked to these drugs have been saved from drug abuse and addiction, he said. Gold prices in the national capital continue to hit new highs, rising by Rs. 475 to Rs. 51,946 per 10 gram on Friday on the back of gains in the international prices of the precious metal and a rupee depreciation according to the HDFC Securities. In a previous trade, it had closed at Rs. 51,471 per 10 gram. Silver, however, declined by Rs. 109 to Rs. 62,262 per kg from Rs. 62,371 per kg on Thursday. Spot gold prices for 24 carats in Delhi continue to hit new highs, rising by Rs. 475 with recovery in international gold prices and a rupee depreciation, HDFC Security Senior Analyst Tapan Patel said. The rupee slipped 8 paisa and settled at 74.83 against the US dollar on Friday as weak domestic equities and escalating tension between the US and China weighed on investor sentiments. In the international market, gold was quoting higher at USD 1,897 per ounce and silver was trading with marginal gain at USD 22.70 per ounce. Increased tension between the US and China and worries over growing coronavirus cases are expected to increase safe haven demand for the precious metal, he said. That is all for today's news bulletin. Stay tuned to Radio Center News for more updates.